Hello everyone. In today's video, we'll demonstrate how you can easily construct a custom multimodal AI application. This will be facilitated by new capabilities from Google Cloud's AI suite and an API-focused design that will keep everything very low code and low effort. We will craft a custom web application together and power the whole system through some basic Python code, including the use of the Flask web application framework. Despite our setup being relatively uncomplicated, we have a relatively production-grade foundation here. This includes the use of a proper vector database to reinforce our multimodal system and the use of battle-tested web technologies. The heart of our architecture is the new Multimodal Embeddings API provided by Google, which incorporates the latest and most advanced Google Cloud AI capabilities within your application. As a pay-per-use pricing model, there's no licensing or upfront costs to deal with. As far as querying, searching, and clustering on top of our embeddings, we'll showcase an example of k-means clustering. Milvus excels at tasks such as vector similarity search, but falls short when it comes to turnkey clustering. But don't fret, we have a well-defined approach for the clustering using a powerful Python ML framework, JAX. All the demonstration code along with the diagram file will be made available in the video description for your reference, revision, and reuse. The only prerequisite step is that we need to ensure Vertex AI APIs are enabled. On opening the Vertex AI dashboard, if the required APIs are not enabled, you will receive a prompt to do so. The Multimodal Embedding API can be found in the Model Garden, where we can see model details, API details, example code snippets, and documentation links. For an easy development experience, we'll use the Cloud Shell IDE. Of course, you may use whichever IDE you prefer. All you need is an authenticated connection to Google Cloud in that IDE. Let's get started by setting up a directory for our application. Our initial step will be to set up our frontend files, which we'll place in a static directory. After understanding the required capabilities from the frontend code, we'll fill out those capabilities in our Flash backend. We'll check out the HTML in the browser shortly, but essentially, it comprises a couple of forms for image and text data uploads, in addition to a couple of divs for previewing those images and text snippets. We'll then be doing a multimodal clustering over those assets. To make this more concrete, imagine that we received a set of pictures for new products on our website and wish to automatically match those images to their associated products. For this, we can use our custom multimodal AI app. The JavaScript file gives us a canvas for implementing our front-end logic. We have a couple of form uploads for images and product descriptions, and that uploaded data will just be sent to our website backend. Later, we'll build out the associated backend saving and embedding generation code. As we upload the data, we'll showcase previews of those image and text assets in the user interface. Next up is the actual multimodal clustering part. What this does is quite powerful, yet relatively simple to implement. It performs k-means clustering across both our images and texts based on a k-value that we provide. Say, for instance, we wish to categorize our images and textual data into four distinct concept-based groups. We'd set our k-value to 4, hit this cool-looking brain icon, and voila, clustering initiated. We'll be using distinct background colors to signify which assets belong to which clusters. Now, time for the meat of the demonstration, integrating our backend logic. Let's get cracking and create an app file for our Flask code. We also need to install all the required Python packages. This application code is structured around routes, which are pretty much API calls from our front end to the back end. We'll initialize the Flask application and create a connection to the Milvus vector database. You might recall that this database is essential for storing our text and image embeddings. When a request to the root directory is sent, our response is straightforward. We serve up the index.html file. Operating within a Flask app means adding the static folder to our front-end code. As soon as the upload action is triggered, we'll generate embeddings for the uploaded file. This procedure involves a handful of steps, including getting an access token, saving the image locally on our application file system, and encoding our image into Base64 data for the Multimodal Embedding API endpoint. With our image embedding in hand, we'll pass that along to our Milvis collection, including with it some metadata like the image's name. If, alternatively, the upload gives us text data, we'll run a similar but simpler process. We'll take that data directly, no special encoding, and generate an embedding before storing it in the Milvis collection. Next, we have this short code snippet that enables storing and previewing images within our Flask app. When the brain icon is clicked, the clustering process is triggered. Using the user-provided k-value, all the embeddings across all our product images and product descriptions are sent to the k-means function, which will reside in a separate Python file and is powered by JAX. The rest of our code is largely utility and cleanup functions. To keep things simpler for our proof of concept, we've decided to drop the data in Milvis each time we kickstart the application, but you can always tweak this process to fit your requirements. The Milvis collection and associated index are specified explicitly. Fields include the all-important multimodal embedding, a 1408 length embedding, and metadata like image file path and text descriptions. The index, which specifies Euclidean distance, gives us a foundation for querying and searching patterns across our vectors. We're almost there. We just need our Milvis instance and k-means logic. For a simple Milvis setup, we'll launch an instance on our localhost. We'll use Docker Compose, which we can run in detached mode to ensure that our Milvis instance keeps chugging away without tying up the terminal. You can find the guidance for Docker Compose in the Milvis documentation. The k-means calculation calls upon a few helper functions, but is ultimately a straightforward implementation of the k-means algorithm. The number of these clusters is conditional on the k parameter passed to our k-means function. Since it's not the focus of this video, we won't spend time discussing the k-means theory and algorithm. Looking back at our app code, which calls this k-means, we see that we're supplying our embeddings and a k-value derived from our front end, which is the integer input at the top here. Now let's get this application started and check it out. After tinkering with the ports to avoid any port mapping, we'll use a web preview to test our app out. As we add images or descriptions, we dynamically compute their embeddings and store them in our Milvis database. Looks like we have an error related to the uploaded images directory, which we will be able to promptly fix. With our product images and product descriptions all set, let's try out our multimodal k-means clustering. Adjusting the clusters to 3, we attempt coordinated matching of product images to their associated descriptions. Not surprisingly, we find that our wrench photo matches the product description for a wrench. The same holds true for the gramophone and the necklace. This is a great sanity check for our clustering process. To illustrate the clustering concept further, let's reduce our value to 2 and rerun the clustering. Following this, we observe that the algorithm sees the most conceptual connection across the wrench image, wrench description, gramophone image, and gramophone description. Meanwhile, the necklace is more conceptually distinct. Since this video is a part of our new AI series, we're continuing our AI safety donation program. We'll donate $1 for every 10 channel subscriptions from this video. If we've helped you out with this video, consider helping out the channel and the great folks working on critical AI safety research by subscribing or donating directly. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Please enjoy responsibly.